For an all-electric society to become a reality, a lasting solution is needed that addresses the storage and transport of energy generated from renewable sources. Furthermore, liquid and gaseous fuels will still be needed as well. It is primarily the mobility sector that will continue to depend on fuel in the long term. In future, the various fuels will be produced using clean electricity. There are places in the world where clean solar power can be generated in abundance. In other areas, the weather conditions make it impossible to cover the demand sufficiently. And of course, solar power cannot be harnessed at night. How do we balance out this disparity? What can be done with surplus capacity? And what should be done during periods of low sunlight? The solution is power to X, where X is the variable representing various energy-rich gases, liquids, and chemicals. These synthetic fuels are also known as e-fuels. How does it work? During periods of sunlight, the generated surplus capacity of clean solar power is used to initiate electrolysis. Energy-rich hydrogen is produced from water and can be used in many applications. However, other fuels are also needed for certain applications. In this case, CO2 from the atmosphere is bonded with hydrogen. Suitable catalysts can be used for the climate-neutral production of various synthetic fuels. For example, methanol for motor vehicles, jet fuel for airplanes, or gas for heating or energy regeneration. Therefore, energy converted from surplus capacity can already be stored and transported in the existing infrastructure used today. For example, using pipelines or gas tankers. With these e-fuels providing additional energy storage, sufficient clean and climate-neutral energy is always available at any time and anywhere in the world. This technology is therefore playing a crucial role in making an all-electric society a reality.